greetings from the American Diabetes Association Scientific Sessions in Philadelphia, the largest diabetes meeting in the world. I'm Anna Baker, and I'm here with Dr. Robert Ratner, Chief Scientific and Medical Officer for the association. First and foremost, Dr. Ratner, let me say welcome aboard because you recently joined the association.
Thank you, Anna. It's a pleasure to finally be officially with the ADA as opposed to a volunteer, which I have been for 30 years.
Yes, I was interested to learn that this is actually your 30th scientific sessions. How has the science changed since 1982?
Everything's changed since 1982. The original session that I went to had maybe 3,000 people. There were three simultaneous sessions. It was divided as basic science, clinical science, and behavioral and education. And that was it. Now we have eight simultaneous sessions going on. We have 15,000 people. It's grown enormously. And the science has evolved along with that. We have so much more that we can do to help patients with diabetes. We understand the disease better. We have far more therapeutic targets. Now we're able to control many of the complications, which back in 1982 were running rampant.
And how does it feel now to be on the other side, on American Diabetes Association staff instead of attendee?
Well, this year's kind of an interesting transition for me because I still have scientific presentations here at the sessions. But I'm now beginning to understand what it takes to put on this show. All of the legwork, all of the people to make sure everything runs on time, and the science really is the hallmark. We don't let the logistics get in the way. All of that runs so smoothly, and that's a real testament to the staff of the ADA.
No, it really is. And speaking of science, what piece of science are you most looking forward to hearing this week?
There's so much good science that's going to be presented at the ADA this year, from large clinical trials like the TINSEL-2D and the TODAY trial to the ORIGIN trial, so that we begin to understand what are the long-term side effects of insulin, and we know how to deal with patients with type 2 diabetes in adolescence. The TINSEL-2D trial looks at inflammation, and then all of the individual new scientific discoveries that get presented in the oral sessions and the posters. It should be very exciting.
Very exciting indeed. Thank you so much for your time. Reporting from Philadelphia, this is Anna Baker with the American Diabetes Association.